Time for Inside Slant. Andrew Greif from the Oregonian joins us again here on the Pac-12 Network. And Andrew, always appreciate you stopping by with us. A little bit earlier today, you were at Mark Helfrich's press conference. What's sort of the big takeaway from what he was saying to the media?
He was saying that the opening season loss to Northwestern for Stanford was a complete anomaly, and that the team you've seen the last 8 weeks when they run off this 8-game winning streak is the real team. He puts a lot of stock into just how tough it is to game plan for Stanford when you have 7-8 offensive linemen. That's something for a kind of a spread team to really have a hard time simulating on the scout team, and that's kind of what makes Stanford so difficult. Defensively, as he said, rinse, repeat, same type of defense, very strong, and he has total respect for what the Cardinal are doing.
All right, so if the week one loss for Stanford was an anomaly, would you make the same case for some of the defeats that Oregon has had this season, considering the health of Vernon Adams? I would think that this team is vastly different right now, the way they're playing with Vernon healthy, than they were when he wasn't.
They are completely different. However, some of those losses you could definitely say were also a product of a defense that really was trying to find its way. They're still very young in the secondary, but that's something that was even more apparent against Utah, against Washington State, and going on and on. So even though Vernon is back, I think the defense is still something that a lot of people have questions about. But when you look at the offense, as you said, the passing efficiency is up markedly from where it was when he was hurt. The yards per completion, third down conversion, they're kind of across the board, the metrics would show that this is the team everyone thought they would have during fall camp.
Well, I'm glad you put it like that, because I think about Oregon, and no disrespect to my guy Nick Aliotti, who I know is in Eugene right now, probably watching the show cringing at what I'm about to say, but I think about the Ducks as an offensive team, and you talk about sort of this turnaround that we're seeing because of Vernon Adams and because of his health and because maybe he's getting more reps. So what's the feel in Eugene right now? Are people buying this turnaround?
I think they're buying it with the caveat that the defense is still something that you're not quite sure is going to hold. That the performance against Jared Goff was by far his worst performance of the year. That might be the worst he plays against any team the last two seasons, and considering Oregon's trouble in the secondary, that was really promising. But I think what people, even if that maybe makes people shy off a little bit from the chances, you have to look at Oregon's run game. That's something they've done for the last 10 years, is lead the Pac-12 in rushing. It's kind of their bread and butter. The fact they're getting back to it more and more as the weeks go on, 477 rushing yards last week, that's kind of a sign, I take it, that these things are kind of moving back to normal as it was 2-3 years ago, and they were really rolling.
It's crazy, because you talk about some of those numbers and them running the football, and yet Royce Freeman's name hasn't maybe gotten as much notoriety, considering some of the yardage that he's been able to put up this season. And he's going to be a major handful for a Stanford defense. But I look at this game between Oregon and Stanford and the way it's gone these last few years, and knowing what's on the line in this particular matchup, how difficult is it to handicap, considering the history between these two teams?
Yeah, it's extremely difficult. I mean, you look at back when Kevin Hogan first came into Autzen Stadium as a freshman, no one would have expected that. That was one of Oregon's very best teams, and yet Stanford comes in and wins in a shocker. You can't count out games like that or results like that from happening. That's why 3 weeks ago, this Stanford game looked like an absolute lock for the Cardinal. But Oregon has this confidence. You could even tell right after the Cal game, a lot of the players were saying, they were already spinning it forward, saying, this gives us a lot of opportunity and a lot of confidence to go into Palo Alto and maybe stun people, because they said, no one is talking about us. This would be our opportunity to get back in that conversation.
All right, so then what is Oregon holding on to defensively from that side of the football to feel good about slowing down a Cardinal team that's been, let's face it, they've been rolling on offense?
Yeah, it would have to be, I think you have to go back just 1 week ago to Cal, holding Jared Goff to, I believe, 18 of 41 passing. I keep harping on it, but that was by far the best performance of the secondary all year. Can that be replicated? I don't know. We haven't seen back-to-back weeks of really solid play in the secondary yet. But the key strength is the defensive line, and basically DeForest Buckner and Alex Balducci, two seniors, two guys who played exceptionally well. Even Buckner, even though he's got a big wrap, a cast on his right hand from an injury, he still is playing extremely well one-handed. You have to, though, back that up with good linebacker play and good secondary play. Both have been question marks all season, and one good game, particularly good game against Cal, isn't necessarily going to erase that.
Andrew Greif from the Oregonian, good enough to stop by with us. Andrew, we love having you on the show. Thanks so much for the time.
Of course, anytime, Mike. Thank you.